Paul, we're going to come up with a great Raw interactive question of the night. What do you think Eric Bischoff is going to do with the vacant World Heavyweight Championship tonight? There's your choices. Awarded to Benoit, awarded to Edge, awarded to Triple H, or arranged for a triple threat rematch. We're going to have the results for you later on tonight.
Let's get on WWE.com. The results later tonight live.
You've got to explain to Bischoff that you are a movie star, a best-selling author, and we all know you're the greatest wrestler alive today. He's got to understand that you are the only real world heavyweight champion.
You know what? If he doesn't listen to that, then I'm going to make him.
I would see that if I was you.
Well, you wouldn't do that if you were me, huh?
That's right, I wouldn't do that.
Is that it, Dave? What would you have me do then, huh? Would you have me go into Bischoff's office begging and pleading? No. Is that what you'd have me do, huh? Because I'm not going
to
do that.
I'm not asking you to beg. I wouldn't tell you to beg to anybody. You're the game. Be the game. Play the game. Bischoff wants to book us in a rematch from last week. Big deal. That's fine. You go out there and dominate like only you can. Don't tell Bischoff who deserves to be the world champion. Show him. And after all said and done, you're standing there, middle of the ring, hands held high. You will know without a shadow of a doubt who the real champion is.
Look out. Watch it. Oh, there you go.
Man, that loosens some teeth, no doubt about that.
He don't have any teeth anyway. It looks like his tongue's in jail when he smiles now. Here you go. Oh, no!
Triple H may need a trick to the business as well. As Benoit got his foot right in the mouth, right in the face of the game.
Tag out, game. Time to tag out. In the long arm.
Well, Benoit needs to make a tag as well. Triple H, being encouraged by Ric Flair at ringside. Batista ready for the tag, and so is Chris Jericho.
There you go.
And there's the tag.
Batista. Oh, no. Batista taking as well.
Batista and Jericho now. They'll leave him in. A reversal by the Animal. Oh, what a shot on Triple H.
That's a cheap shot of the night.
The hard shot, Batista setting that face and a cross body. Right cut midair.
Oh, this is impressive. This is so impressive. Oh, no.
And the top block.
There's the cheap shot of the night.
Impressive move. Looking for the walls of Jericho.
Look at the leg strength, though.
Batista overpowering Jericho. Oh, right toe hold. Nice move.
Oh, yeah. You're feeling, aren't you?
Jericho using his quickness. Nice front toe hold. Fall.
Come on, Batista. Stay on him.
Batista downstairs. God. Hard shot to the shoulder presses. Oh, wait. Gonna be a power bomb. Is it time? Jericho trying to fight out and does. Jericho fighting out of the predicament. Running in Zaguri. Running in Zaguri and down goes the 317 pounder. Lion Tamer. Connecting. Jericho's got it here.
Oh, here comes the game.
Triple H trying to interfere. Just go back to the outside.
Nate! Something, Nate!
Clear on the apron. Springboard drop kick. Jericho is dominating here. And now makes the tag to Chris Benoit.
We got trouble here now.
Benoit, a diving headbutt. That suicide-like diving headbutt found its mark.
He's gone.
Sharpshooter.
And you know what, Benoit hooks a sharpshooter on and he has it.
On Evolution's Animal.
No, Batista, don't give up.
And
don't
do it. Oh, no. The game in. The crossface. The game illegally in. Got the crossface on it.
Don't tap.
And Batista, I got the Animal. Just pulled. Oh, spine buster. A brutal spine buster.
He got it.
And Batista has been wrong with the spine buster.
Impressive.
Batista, very impressive here. What a tag team match. All four men giving us everything they had here tonight. Physically intense. So physically intense. Wow. Batista certainly brought it home for Evolution.
Let's see this one more time. There you see Benoit had that crippler crossface locked on the gate. But the gate wasn't the legal man. The animal was the legal man. And that move should be illegal out of nowhere.
That move would beat any man. Man, what a tag team match. What a Raw.
Yeah, you want to check out? Let's show everybody the results. Here's what you thought was the answer to the question, what Eric Bischoff should do with the vacant world title. What'd you think? What'd you vote? Well, wait a minute. They think that they should arrange for a triple threat rematch.
That's a landslide.
Yes.
58%.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Triple H, I'm going to make my decision in the ring. Eric, please. Make the right decision here, okay? Listen, I know you and I have had our differences in the past, Eric, but that world title is my life, okay? Being world champion is all that I am. Eric, I'm asking you, please, to make the right decision here, because it's what's right for business, Eric, okay? Listen. I'm a nine-time world champion, Eric. All right, Raw, listen, please. Raw's my show. Raw's what I am. The world champion is what I am, Eric. And Edge and Benoit, just wrestlers, okay? I'm a household name, Eric. Worldwide, I am a household name and people know me. People know me as the world champion, Eric. I'm asking you, please put everything between us aside, please. Do what's right for business, Eric. Do what's right for me.
Triple H, I'm gonna take all of these things you've just told me into consideration.
From New Year's Revolution, where the now vacant world title will be decided in one of the most sadistic structures in the history of WWE, the Elimination Chamber. Four superstars will be locked in individual glass chambers that will be opened at random while two superstars start the match. After five eliminations, the last man standing will become the winner. Needless to say, the competitor released last into the chamber has the greatest advantage of becoming the new world champion. Which brings me to tonight, because tonight I have a couple of surprises. First of all six competitors in the Elimination Chamber match are gonna have what I like to call a beat the clock night. That's right, Randy Orton, Chris Benoit, Edge, Batista, Y2J, Chris Jericho, and Triple H will all have one-on-one matches with unknown opponents. And it's very quite simple. You see, the man who defeats his opponent in the least amount of time will be the last man released into the chamber. And since time is of the essence, please allow me to introduce to you our very special guest timekeeper and the winner of the 2004 Raw Diva Search, Christy Hemme!
All right, very good. What a blockbuster way to start off Monday Night Raw. She's going to be the timekeeper for tonight. I'd like to spend some time with Christy, wouldn't you?
I'm sure you would.
And boy, I'll tell you what. What a night that Bischoff has lined up tonight, ladies and gentlemen. All six men in the Elimination Chamber to determine the vacant World Heavyweight title will be in one-on-one competition tonight, King.
But they don't even know who their opponents are going to be.
And they're going to be playing Beat the Clock.
Wow. Look at Christy.
Oh, baby.
Oh, but wait, there's more. Should any one of the competitors tonight lose to his opponent, then that man will be replaced in the Elimination Chamber by the athlete who defeated him. Oh, and last thing. There's going to be a very special, and I mean very special, guest referee for the Elimination Chamber match, who I will announce later on this evening. But without any further ado, let's start off Beat the Clock with none other than the Ayatollah of Rock and Roller, Y2J, Chris Jericho.
What an awesome night to be with you live.
I mean, the whole concept of it is embarrassingly bad.
Champ, I know there's a lot of concern about what's going on tonight. I know you guys are worried about who your opponents might be.
Of course we're concerned. We're both concerned. Hey, neither one of you, we don't even know who our opponents are.
I'm not concerned. I don't care who this is.
No, I mean, I'm not concerned either. But I'm just saying, you know, and you're not even concerned a little bit. I mean, you don't even know who your opponents are.
Okay. Why should I be concerned? I'm confident. Why shouldn't I be? Aren't you?
Of course I'm confident. When have you seen me not be confident, huh? I'm the game, man. I'm their cerebral assassin. Of course I'm confident. Tell you what, I'm so confident, I got $100 in my wallet. It says I beat my guy faster than you beat your guy.
$100.
Yeah, come on, I'm confident in you.
Come on. Hey,
we're on, all right.
Uh-huh. Hey, let's get serious, okay? Big picture here is the Elimination Chamber match. The World Heavyweight Championship is at stake. And you know that tonight you will score the fastest fall. You will come off with the quickest win. And you know, big man, in the Elimination Chamber match, the World Heavyweight Champion will be Triple H.
Yeah, man.
That's right. It's always been that way.
I'm doing a job. I'll
just be professional as I can. But not worth your effort.
This contest is a Beat the Clock match scheduled for one fall. Soon to be making his way to the ring from Washington, D.C., weighing 318 pounds, Batista.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, one thing I can say is that Batista's got a time of 5 minutes and 43 seconds to beat that was set by Chris Benoit a few minutes ago against the biggest man on the Raw roster, Viscera. I don't know who Batista's going to face here.
You heard Batista say earlier, he doesn't care who he's going to face, JR. He's confident. He's ready. And from the looks of him, I don't think he should care who he's going to face.
Batista very confident, King.
Now, tonight, WWE Raw is brought to you by WWE SmackDown vs. Raw. Two worlds collide on PlayStation 2.
And by White Noise, the most disturbing
film in years.
WWE Raw is brought to you by WWE SmackDown vs. Raw. Two worlds collide on PlayStation 2.
And by White Noise, the most disturbing film in years. Starts January 7th.
And by Xbox. Xbox, it's good to play together.
Oh, well,
and
look here.
From Detroit, Michigan, weighing 275 pounds, Rhino.
And the Man Beast has a chance to make his mark here. Batista, yes, he's got to beat Benoit's time of 5:43, but let's get this straight. Batista's also got to win. If Rhino wins, King, Rhino's in the main event.
Well, I understand that. And Rhino would love to be in that Elimination Chamber. He wouldn't care who his opponents are. He would love a shot at that World Heavyweight Championship. But look at Batista.
This is the fifth of six matches that we will see here tonight live from the men involved, the Elimination Chamber.
Well, I think we can probably count on one thing. You see the confidence on the face of Batista. He plans on, I don't think he plans on making short work out of Rhino. I think he wants to play around. I think he wants to prolong the agony of Rhino. He wants to beat the time, don't get me wrong. But he's not going to be in any hurry to do it.
Batista connecting with that elbow. Batista, 6 feet six, maybe 6'7", 318 pounds. Well, let's not discount Rhino. Rhino is a phenomenal athlete. And what an opportunity here for Rhino. That doesn't happen very often. Rhino had the momentum. It's like running into a brick wall.
Come on! Well,
look at this.
Come on!
See, come on. Do you realize what we're seeing here? Batista just taunting Rhino. He's not even trying to cover him. He's not really in a hurry to beat Rhino. Because you know why? He's a loyal member of Evolution. And he knows he wants the only man to beat the clock, the man to be the last man in that Elimination Chamber to be Triple H.
Well, I'm glad he can't read lips.
The floor by Rhino! Rhino's gonna upset Batista!
What a near fall! Rhino got the gore!
Look at Rhino, he can't believe Batista kicked out of the gore!
Batista got almost gored out of his boots and now knocked down again to a knee. Rhino in control here. And Rhino's got a chance to win literally the biggest match of his career here on Raw, here and now.
Got another gore. I don't think even Batista can stand two gores.
Oh, look out. God almighty, what a spine buster. Double A version.
Well, that spine buster came out of nowhere. First of all, he took a gore from Rhino, kicked right out of it, and then came out when Rhino went for the second gore. Bam! Batista struck.
Not forget about the clock. It's descending down, and that's the time that Batista's got to beat.
I told you, I don't think Batista wants to beat the clock. He's loyal to Triple H.
And Batista, the sit-down powerbomb. Sounded like a car wreck. Sounded like two 18-wheelers and I-10.
See, he's not even covering Rhino.
Plenty of time.
Plenty of time.
One more,
JR.
Not a human being alive that can withstand one more of that. My God.
Rhino's going to have to try to withstand it.
Batista again with a second sit-down powerbomb.
Wait a minute. What are you doing?
And good God almighty, Batista just blew Benoit's time out of the water.
He obliterated Benoit's time.
What? There is your winner.
And he obliterated Rhino.
Batista.
3 minutes and 2 seconds is the new.
What the hell's he doing? He wasn't supposed to beat the clock, huh? What is his problem? Here you are. What's your problem, huh? This was real simple to understand.
I'm sorry, man.
Huh? No. What were you thinking out there?
Rhino,
you weren't supposed to beat the clock.
Rhino pissed me off. I did what I did. I'm sorry.
Rhino pissed you off. You did what you did. That's your excuse, huh? Listen to me. Why do you have such a problem following a plan, huh? This was real simple.
Hey!
I walked in last.
Now, you are starting to piss me off.
Come on, guys. Hey. We're a unit. We're Evolution. The most powerful thing that ever happened. Let's go. Come on, man. Evolution comes first. Come on, guys. Let's let's regroup. Come on. Come on. Come on, champ. Beat that time.
This Sunday, at New Year's Revolution, Raw is going to crown a new world champion. But before this Sunday, we've got some business to take care of here tonight. Now, last week on Raw, all six participants in the Elimination Chamber had an opportunity to play Beat the Clock. Well, this week on Raw, all six participants in the Elimination Chamber are going to have an opportunity to beat each other. Because tonight on Monday Night Raw, we're going to start the new year off with Batista versus Chris Benoit. But it gets better yet. Because Edge will be taking on Y2J Chris Jericho. And believe it or not, here in Uniondale, Long Island, New York, one of the greatest world champions of all time, Triple H, will be facing Randy Orton.
Oh, look at this. The 10-ton structure, a new world champion, will be crowned this Sunday. That's the bottom line here. Oh, the Enziguri! The Enziguri by Benoit taking down Batista.
My question to you, JR, is will it be one of these two men, Benoit or Batista, crown the new world heavyweight champion Sunday?
Well, I'll tell you, that's hard to say, but how can you bet against Batista as all five of the other competitors will already have been in the match in the Elimination Chamber?
Yeah, but if Benoit wins this match right here, I think my money might be on him. Look at this.
Benoit, that dropkick, very resourceful move. Before, here we go, the cover, the cover. And this time, it's Batista that refused to stay down. Batista got his shoulders off the canvas.
Oh, wow. That huge knee buried right into the midsection of the Wolverine. Look at this now. Oh, not again.
Another suplex. Oh, with authority around the back of the head. A driving belly-to-back suplex. And Chris Benoit now going up top.
I'll tell you something, when you get that from Benoit, it's like being in a car wreck. Your whole body's never the same. Look at this!
Diving headbutt from the top. Will this be enough to keep the animal down? There's the cover, the hook of the leg, and the three. Oh, not the three. A long two count.
Oh, my gosh. Can you imagine what that Elimination Chamber match is going to be like?
Oh. 2 miles of chain. It's 36 feet in diameter. 16 feet from the roof to the floor.
It's hell on earth, JR. That's what it is. Hell on earth. I've never been in one. Don't want to be in one.
It is Satan's structure, to say the least.
Oh, look out, look out.
Oh, look out. Crossface. Benoit taking the crossface on Batista.
He's got it locked in.
Benoit's got the cripple crossface on Batista. And it's a matter of time now.
There's not a Batista, don't tap!
There's not a living human being that can...
He's about to... Don't tap! He's gonna tap! He's fighting!
Batista's about to tap!
Listen to these fans! They think Batista's about to tap! Get your arm out!
Batista's got... Oh, my God! My God, look at the strength! My God, oh, my God!
He just snapped!
Benoit's headed an exposed turnbuckle!
Not once, but about four times!
Batista ramming Benoit's head into the exposed turnbuckle. My God, Batista rose from the cripple crossface.
Have you ever seen that done?
Hell no.
Come on, Batista, shake it off. He did. Look at this.
Batista dimming Benoit's lights. And now Batista, the animal, sent that powerbomb. Batista bomb. The hook of the leg. And Batista wins it. God, how impressive is that animal?
Here is your winner, Batista.
Ladies and gentlemen, he'll come into the competition, the sixth and final man inside the Elimination Chamber this Sunday with a distinct advantage, King. How can you bet against Batista at New Year's Revolution?
I don't know, JR. All bets are off after seeing what I just witnessed. Can we see that one more time? We've got... looking at the next World Heavyweight Champion. Look at Benoit had that crippler crossface locked in, and Dare, I've never seen this. Look at the power and the strength of Batista.
It is freakish strength. Scary power as Batista to get right back up to his feet, and then this. Oh, shut down powerbomb.
That's a Batista bomb. That's especially.
Man, what impact. What impact. And what a way to start off what will be, no doubt, one of the hottest Raws in memory. Boy, this.
Came out of the crossface. He picked him up. He walked around the ring. He banged his head on the turnbuckle. Then the powerbomb. What a way to start 2005 for Evolution. It's fantastic. He comes out of the Elimination Chamber last.
I didn't think it would work out with this.
Hey, man, work out. Hey, let me tell you. Hey, Killer, whoa, come here. Hey, man, I've never seen you look finer, brother. You destroyed Benoit.
Oh, I feel good.
Destroyed him. Triple H, all you have to do now is beat the four other guys. Then the big man, Batista, comes out last. The Elimination Chamber does all the dirty work. Destroys them. Power bombs all four of them. And then, just like we planned, from day one, the world title goes back around your waist, champ. Woo! What a night! You're awesome. Awesome.
And I know I can count on you, big man.
That's right.
Right?
That's right. And I can count on you, right?
You can. Right. I know you can, man.
And I can count on you to give me that $100 you owe me, too, right?
What'd you just say?
$100 you owe me. You owe me $100. We made a bet last week. You lost. I won. I want my money. I beat my guy faster than you beat your guy. You lost the bet. I want my $100.
Rick, give him $100.
Yeah, I'll follow here.
Whoa.
I got a coupon.
You didn't make the bet. I don't want your money. I don't want Rick's money. He didn't make the bet. You didn't lose the bet. You lost the bet. I want your money. Will you get a sense of humor? Relax, man, I'm just kidding. What, your money?
Hey, champ. Ready for tonight, man? You're looking good.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Hey, let me tell you something. Batista and I are gonna be out there tonight, just like Batista will be at New Year's Resolution for the Elimination Chamber match. Your back is covered, brother.
I'm cool with you out there tonight, Rick, but, Dave, I'm gonna have you hang back. You know, the, Elimination Chamber, it's four guys I gotta beat to become world champion, and I'm gonna need you there. I'm gonna need you backing me up. But tonight, it's just one guy.
Ah, but wait, champ.
It's just Randy Orton. And I'm going to show the whole world that Orton was nothing but a tag-along the whole time. Cool?
It's cool with me. Let me tell you something. I've always known you were the man. You've never needed anybody. You're Triple H. And you're going to be the World Heavyweight Champion again.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
See you out there, man.
See ya.
Hey, man. I told Rick you didn't need me out there, but you know how he gets, man. He's, you know, kind of stuck in his way.
I know
you can take Orton, man, so I'll just hang back here and watch you do your thing. I won't come out. Won't get involved in your match.
That's cool. Yeah, that's cool.
Unless he really starts kicking your ass. But we know that's not gonna happen, man. Lighten up, come on. Orton.
RKO.
The Game and Orton is next.
Orton in a great leverage position there with the neck crimp in that sleeper hold. And oh my God, head to head. Orton and the referee went head to head.
What a brilliant move by the Game.
I think Triple H pulled Orton and the referee right together. I know this, heads cracked. Referee is down. What is, Flair's got the damn ring bell. Flair just slid the ring bell into Triple H. And the referee's not able to do a damn thing about it.
Finish him. Finish him.
Triple H, that ring bell will take Orton's head off.
He's not, Randy Orton's not even gonna make it to the Revolution. Oh,
downstairs with Orton. And Flair gets nailed off the apron. The Nature Boy nailed off the apron. The referee is still down. And now Orton's got that weapon.
That's not fair. That's not fair. Randy Orton should be disqualified right now. Ring the bell.
Referee didn't see it. And wait a minute. Oh, Batista. My God, what a clothesline. And there's Benoit.
Where did Chris Benoit come from?
Benoit and Batista got it on earlier tonight. And they're getting it on here now. Benoit and Batista fighting on the outside. Referee is down. This is cut off. This is time. Shawn Michaels, the special referee Sunday.
Shawn Michaels isn't supposed to be here until Sunday.
Michaels is tipping on the referee who's down. And Edge,
what?
And Edge, what the hell is Edge doing?
Edge is going to spear Shawn. I love it. Edge is going to spear Shawn. Turn around, Shawn. Please turn around.
Edge just pours a spear. And there's Jericho. Jericho intercepting Edge.
What the hell is Jericho doing down here?
Edge was no doubt going to break Shawn Michaels in half. It is a fallout. It's chaos. And Jericho with that suicide punter right over the top.
Why can't Jericho? Wait a second. But now Shawn Michaels thinks he's the referee. He's counting.
Michaels has taken it over. The referee's incapacitated. Michaels is the official now.
Well, Triple H looks like he just saw a ghost in him.
That's what it's about. Shawn Michaels is a special referee Sunday. That's what it's all about, Triple H. Whether you like it or you don't like it.
Yeah, this Sunday, JR, not right now. And that's what Triple H is telling Shawn Michaels.
Wait a minute. Randy Orton's up. Orton's up.
Don't turn around. No.
It's all about you.
And there you see it, ladies and gentlemen, the new World Heavyweight Champion for the 10th time. Triple H is at the top of the mountain. Jim Ross is here in the King Lawler, live from the Home Depot Center here in South Florida. And King, what a hellacious night it was in paradise 24 hours ago.
It was that indeed, but look at Triple H, the battered and bruised as he is. He still has that smile because he has the World Championship close to his chest, but he's shoving it right down the throats of these fans who never thought, I think most of these fans never thought that Triple H would win that title last night.
There is one man that was so dominant last night in the Elimination Chamber that he eliminated not only Chris Benoit, but Chris Jericho. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a member of Evolution, and I am proud to say that he is my friend. He is the destroyer. He is the most dominant force in this business today. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare yourselves for the beast, Batista.
It's really hard to argue, King, about what the game just said in describing Evolution's animal, Batista, who was absolutely physically dominating inside the Elimination Chamber in San Juan last night.
No doubt about it. Dominant is the word for the animal in the Elimination Chamber. He's right. He eliminated not only Chris Benoit, but Chris Jericho as well. Boy, look at him today.
Evolution back on top of the world. This unit, the most dominating unit in the history of this business.
I know JR, that Batista's everything that you said, and he is, but all these remarks from Triple H, you don't think that the game is sort of sucking up to Batista a little bit, do you?
And that's an interesting question. There they are, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey!
Wait a second, uh-oh. Randy Orton, a former member of Evolution, a former world's champion.
And I like the looks of this.
It takes a lot of courage for one man to approach the ring with Evolution standing in the ring.
Your little love fest, Triple H. But as usual, you're only telling one side of the story. Look, guys, it's the Legend Killer. Or should I say Buzz Killer? You know, Randy, this is called a celebration. Celebrations are for winners. You are a loser. So why don't you hit the road, Jack? Last night, Triple H, you pinned me in the Elimination Chamber. You pinned me in the Elimination Chamber with Batista's help after he had been eliminated. Now it's obvious Batista has your back. But it's a shame that you don't have his. It's a shame that you don't have Batista's back. And I got the footage to prove it.
Talking about Orton, don't be ridiculous. There's no footage that shows anything. What footage? What footage?
What footage is he talking about?
The footage from New Year's Revolution, the footage from last night, which clearly shows that you had an opportunity to
to stop me pinning Batista with an RKO. You had an opportunity, Triple H, to save Batista. You had an opportunity, Triple H, to have Batista's back, and you didn't take it. Orton, listen to me. It's a very good imagination you have. The only footage you have is gonna show you taking a cheap shot at Batista to eliminate him. Now, if you hadn't done that, the Elimination Chamber would have ended up me against Batista the way it should have been. We don't need to see your footage to show us what you did. So, guys, let's just get out of here, all right?
Let's just wait a minute. I think I'd like to see that footage.
Hey, hey, you heard the man. Roll the footage. Now there we go. I'm about to be powerbombed right here by Batista. I'm about to be powerbombed. I gain an advantage right here. I hit the RKO on Batista. Now watch Triple H in the background. He gets up. He sits back down. You had an opportunity. You had an opportunity, Triple H. You had an opportunity to make the save on Batista, and you didn't take it.